Hello, my beautiful ladies. It's Greta here, ladies relationship coach. And today's topic for you ladies is why he should pay. Okay, so I know it's a very controversial topic and I'm expecting lots of interesting comments under this video. However, as I said, the topic is why he should pay, and if he doesn't pay, there is no second date. So let me share with you ladies five reasons on why he should pay. Number one reason, when the guy is paying on the date, he is trying to impress you, he is making an effort, and he is investing in you. If he is doing all of these three things, it means he is into you. If he is not paying for the date or he is splitting the bill to 50-50, it simply means he is not that into you and he doesn't believe that you're worthy the investment. So therefore, ladies, simply you do not go on the second date with him. Reason number two, does it make you a gold digger just because you are letting him pay for the date? No, it doesn't. How are you a gold digger just because you're letting him feed you? You can go home and cook that food yourself. You can go with your friends to eat and to the nicer place, to the posher place, to a better place. It doesn't make you a gold digger just because you are letting him pay for the date. You are not asking him for the money. He is investing in you from his own free will. Well, he is making an effort towards you. He is trying to impress you. It's very important to appreciate it when a guy does that. It definitely does not make you a gold digger. As simple as that. Reason number three, so following from the reason number two, it's actually an investment. It's an effort. It's a guy trying to impress you. For example, let's look at it like this, right? Then the guy is basically, let's say he doesn't have that much money, and when he takes a girl out on a date and he takes her to a nice place and he basically pays for the date, the lady really appreciates it because she knows that he doesn't have that much money and that this is a treat, and it makes her feel great. It makes her feel cared of. It makes her feel feminine. It makes her feel like, oh my god, he really cares. He's making all of this effort trying to show me how much he likes me. So she feels really appreciated. She knows that the guy is making this effort and investing in her because he likes her. It's a proof of a guy liking a girl a lot. At the same time, when the guy has a lot of money and he takes her for dinner, for that date, to a really nice place, she is not going to appreciate this effort as much because he has a lot of money, and for him to treat her for something nice like that, it's very easy. It's quite meaningless. It doesn't require that much of effort because he is, let's say, wealthy, crazy rich. This is why a lot of girls, and actually a lot of videos, even like I think J-Lo has made a video on I don't need your money. It's not saying that she doesn't need the money. It's basically saying I want you to invest in me. I want you to make some effort towards me. So if giving me money is very easy to you, if paying for, like, giving all these presents, paying for dinner, it's very easy for you, I want to see another type of investment, which is go to that bloody field and pick me a bunch of flowers, or take me to a picnic where you're making the sandwiches yourself. You know, so then this effort will be more appreciated from that type of guy than from the guy who doesn't have money and is, you know, like making that effort to take that girl on a date. You see my point? It's all about a guy paying for that date is just to see the effort that he likes you, that it's worth for you to go on that second date with him because he likes you a lot and he is willing to impress you and invest into you. It's nothing to do with the gold digger stuff. So number four, or the tip number four, would be, ladies, let a guy give you freely. All right, just because you want to go to that nicest restaurant in town, it's not up to you. It's up to him how much he wants to invest in you, right? So, for example, if he's asking you out on a date, let him choose the restaurant or let him choose what he is willing to invest into you. If he wants to take you out for a coffee, let him take you out for a coffee. If that's what he's willing to invest into you, a coffee, that's fine. If he wants to go out with you hiking or to the park and just get you some ice cream or water, let him do that. Basically, if he wants to take you to this nice place and treat you to a really nice dinner, let him do that. But the key is, let him give you freely. The tip number five is, I'm actually going to share my own personal story. So it is quite entertaining and I thought, you know what, let's just give it to you guys. So a while back, I think half a year now, I went on this date with a guy, and so first he took me to this kind of cute little restaurant and we didn't order much. Well, I didn't get much. I think I just got some water and some like little starter because I wasn't hungry. He got some food to eat as well. And through the whole date, he was trying to charm me. So the charms are, you're so beautiful, promises, flattery, we're gonna go on holidays together. As always, this is a very common thing to say. I'm gonna buy you this, this, and that. Another common thing to say. It's basically promises, right? So we were talking and I go to the loo, I come back and the bill comes. And when the waiter brings the bill, it was a guy waiter, when the waiter brings the bill, he literally gives the bill to me. Like we sitting at the table, the guy sitting here, I'm sitting here. And the waiter, he puts the bill literally like so close to me. And I was shocked because that has never happened to me before. When the waiter usually brings the bill, he either gives it to the guy or he puts it in the middle of the table. So the waiter giving the bill like literally to me, I was in my head, I was just thinking like, have you brought up girls here before and have you made them pay? Because for a guy, for a man waiter to give this bill directly to me, it makes me very suspicious. So obviously I didn't say that to him. I did not touch the bill. I totally ignored it. He saw that I totally ignored it. So he took it from kind of my side of the table and he paid. And then after that, we went to the rooftop. Really nice place, to the rooftop. We both had like a glass of Prosecco. And during the time, again, he was like, one of my earrings was falling out. And he was like, oh my God, you need new earrings. I'm gonna buy you new earrings. I'm gonna buy you this. You're so beautiful. Anyway, what he does is, after we have the Prosecco, he says, okay, I need to go to the loo. So he asked, so first he lifts his hand. He asks the waiter for the bill, right? For the Prosecco, for the bill. And then he goes to the loo, right? So when he's in the loo, the waitress brings the bill and again puts it, you know, for me basically to pay. I literally ignore it. I don't touch it. In my head, I see his kind of game plan. And in my head, I'm thinking, okay, so for the whole date, I was getting, again, flattery, promises, present promises, all of that basically bullshit. But with your action, you are basically constantly showing me that I am who's gonna be paying for this bill, even though I haven't paid, but you know what I mean. Well, at the same time, I'm also thinking, if I was still then nice Greta, which I was, let's say, 15 years ago, I would be like easily taking the bill and thinking, okay, that's fine, you know, like he paid the last time, or he just needed to go to the loo, or, you know, he just basically, it's an accident, he just had to go to the toilet, you know, like I would have been thinking in a naive way and paid for it. Obviously, now it's a different story. I see his game plan, so I look at it, I don't touch it. He comes back from the toilet. The first place he looks at, it's to the bill. This is literally the first place. So he literally looks like, he comes, he doesn't even look at me, he looks straight into the bill. And then I see him coming back. I get up and I say, now I need to go to the loo. So I go to the loo, I come back, he has paid the bill, right? And then, yeah, and basically this is how it's finished. So we said bye, and he was basically texting me for the next 2 weeks because I was not replying to him anymore. But, yeah. It's, you see, girls, it's like, it's just ridiculous. It's just ridiculous. Yeah. This is an example of how you match the bullshit with the action. So then he is giving you so much bullshit, and his flattery and words and promises don't even match up with him taking a simple bill, even though he took it because I didn't. You know, it's just basically shows that he's just giving you all the bullshit and don't go on that second date. You know, so yeah, that was my story for you girls. And ladies, if you want to know what is a high value man, I have a video for that, and you can find that video just by clicking on this link right here. And if you liked this video, please press like, subscribe to my YouTube channel, join my high value women Facebook group, where we are all in the same boat, learning how to be women of high value and bring out the best in our men. Also join my Instagram, which is called Ladies Relationship Coach. My Instagram is private, ladies only. I do Instagram lives where you can ask me free questions during the lives. And if you would like me to hold your hand and help you to bring out the best in your guy, so he treats you with value, respect, cherishes and adores you, you can book me through my website, which is called ladiesrelationshipcoach.com, and I will be there to help you out. So thank you so much for watching. Have a beautiful day. Kisses from London. Mwah.